Mambo vipi? Welcome back to Learn Swahili with Victor. Karibu tena. Today's lesson is about habitual tense. In Swahili, we use the prefix hu to show the habitual tense. So what we do, we just take the prefix u, we put it to the, we connect it with the verb to show the habitual tense. So, who is called habitual tense? And the habitual tense does not have a subjective prefix. There is no another prefix with habitual tense. What is done? You take the stem or the stem of the verb, you connect with habitual tense, which is who. For example, you take the stem, the verb checker, then you put who becomes who checker. So, there is no any other prefix there before. Okay. This habitual tense, it express the habitual or recurrent action, the action which is normally or always or usually happening. Usually, so habitual, who means usually, generally, always, normally. Okay. That's the way habitual tense to use. So here, habitual tense is who. So who, it means always, usually, normally, generally. Okay. Now let's see examples of these habitual tense. For example, yeah, mimi hulala mchana. Over here, the verb is lala. So we put a prefix u to show the habitual tense. Mimi hulala mchana. I always sleep in the afternoon. Good. Wewe husafiri sana. Wewe husafiri sana. Of course, here, the verb is safiri. Then we put who to show the habitual tense. Wewe husafiri sana. Wewe husafiri sana. You usually travel a lot. Yeye hupenda pombe. Yeye hupenda pombe. The verb here is penda. Penda means like or love. So yeye hupenda pombe. He or she usually likes alcohol or loves alcohol. Sisi hufanya kazi usiku. The verb here is fanya, which means work. So when we say hufanya, sisi hufanya kazi. We usually work at night. Then, ninyi hujifunza Kiswahili. Ninyi hujifunza Kiswahili. Jifunza, that's learn. Then, who is the habitual tense. The prefix shows the habitual tense. Get me? Ninyi hujifunza Kiswahili. You always learn Swahili. Wao uishi vijijini. Wao uishi vijijini. They always live in the village. Wao uishi vijijini. They always live in the village. Basi uondoka asubuhi sana. Basi uondoka asubuhi sana. The bus always leaves very early in the morning. Chakula cha mchana hupikwa mapema. Chakula cha mchana hupikwa mapema. Usually afternoon meals are cooked early or lunch. Usually afternoon meals are cooked early. Okay? That's some of the examples of the habitual tense. Now let's use this chat box to make different sentences. You can see these are pronouns. Now this is the prefix showing the habitual. This is the verb. Then we finish up with the adverb. Then you take one of these, you take habitual tense, then you connect with the verb, you make a sentence by finishing with the adverb. Mimi, for example, yeah, mimi hu penda kahawa. Mimi hu taka utaka mziki. Mimi husikiliza mziki. Mimi huangalia sinema. Mimi huamka mapema. Mimi huoga kila siku. Mimi hufanya kazi nyumbani. Okay? So you can use wewe. Wewe hupenda kahawa. Mimi hutaka mziki. Wewe usikiliza mziki. Wewe huangalia sinema. Wewe huamka kila siku. Wewe huoga mapema. Wewe hufanya kazi kila siku. Yeye hupenda sinema. Yeye hutaka sinema. Yeye husikiliza muziki. Yeye huangalia sinema. Yeye huamka mapema. Yeye huoga Jumapili. Yeye hufanya kazi kila siku. You see? Simple like that. You go to Sisi the same. Sisi upenda kahawa. Sisi utaka mziki. Sisi usikiliza mziki. Sisi uangalia sinema. Sisi uamka kila siku. Au sisi uamka Jumapili. Sisi uamka. Sisi uoga nyumbani. Sisi ufanya kazi Jumapili. Simple like that. You go to ninyi, it's the same thing. Ninyi, let's start with the downward. The downward here. Ninyi ufanya kazi mapema. Ninyi uoga kila siku. Ninyi uamka mapema. Ninyi uangalia sinema. Ninyi usikiliza mziki. Ninyi hutaka kahawa. Ninyi hupenda sinema. You go to wow, it's the same. Okay, now let's do it together with wow. Waho hupenda kahawa. Waho hutaka mziki. Waho husikiliza mziki. Waho huangalia sinema. Waho huamka mapema. Waho huoga kila siku. Waho hufanya kazi nyumbani. That's about habitual tense. That's all about habitual tense. You can see it's very easy, very simple to know. Okay? So the most important thing to take there, take that the prefix which shows the habitual tense in Swahili is who. You connect it with the verb, you make a sentence. Okay? Thank you for watching. First, thank you for watching my video, and thank you for continuing supporting me. For those who have not yet supported me in my Patreon channel, you can go in Patreon, in your browser, let www.patreon.com/Swahili with Victor. I'm repeating, www.patreon.com/Swahili with Victor. Over there, you will see the good videos, more than these. You see a lot of videos, and you can have a live class with me. When you send on there, you can choose one time, you support me over there, then you can communicate and have a live class. So the only way, the easiest way to communicate with me, just send in Patreon, patreon.com/Swahili with Victor. Then we have touch. We're gonna communicate and arrange for Swahili lesson. Asante sana, karibu tena. Let us meet for the next lesson. Okay, karibu, uwe na siku njema.